This is a 12-volt booster pack. This represents your car battery, 12 volts. These are two jumper wires connected to the booster pack. This is 12 volts. This is a 12-volt fire. How long did that take? How long did that fire take? Do you want to learn about electrical protection on your vehicle? Well, that's what the show is about. Stick around. Not there, she got us. Fire. I don't want that. I'm sure you don't. It's designed to prevent fires, but we're going to teach you how it works. It's all about the fuse. The fuse is the most common type of electrical protection. The protection from fire. Your vehicle could catch fire so easy if it wasn't for this little thing here. And we're gonna give you, show you, remember, that's our specialty. We don't just say it, we show you how things work. I'm gonna take a fuse, I'm gonna put it into the circuit, I'm gonna use my jumper wire, I'm gonna do almost exactly the same thing, but all I have done this time is introduce a fuse. I think I can juggle all of these here, and this is the same setup. This is exactly the same setup that I had a minute ago, and let me finish setting up. Okay, this time I have protection. I still have that little piece of paper that caught fire. I'm doing exactly the same thing, but this time I have protection. The protection comes in this fuse. Look for the fire, but watch what happens right here if there is a short circuit. Did you see it? Did you hear it? That's called a burned fuse. It popped, it blew, whatever you want to call it, the protection kicked in. The purpose of protection is to prevent fires. They do an excellent job. Let's explain how a fuse works. A lot of students didn't like electrical because it's a little unfriendly. But I had to come up with interesting, fun ways so they could learn. And this is how I did it. When it came to protection, let me show you what I have down here. I have fuses, right? And the different colors represent different amperage. Now, in our last video, it showed you. Remember, that's our specialty. We show you. We don't just talk about it. We showed you. I'll leave a links in all the descriptions. In this video, this is, if I'm not mistaken, video number 5 on electrical. These fuses are at different ratings, but this is how I made it interesting for the students. I called them pelitos. Pelito is a Spanish word for small hair. What I have here is and look at the white, I have a small, I have a medium, and I have a large. Not only is it small on the outside, it's small on the inside. This is a single strand. These automotive wires are made of multi-strand. A strand. You can barely see the strand on this one. That's the small one. We'll call it the pelitos. All of these pelitos on the medium wire. The pelito is a little more noticeable. I hope you can see it. But on the large one, you can start to see the pelito. We have 3 different size pelitos, and the pelito turns out to be exactly what the fuse does. The pelito turns out to work exactly how the fuse works. So now it's time to show you, not just tell you, how the pelito and the fuse works. Okay, folks, this is how I made it interesting. I would give it a funny name, pelito. It just means a small hair. I would take a multi-strand wire and I would separate it till I had a small one, just like this. Now, I've got my wires ready to go, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna operate that fan. And who remembers from the last video how many amps this guy uses? It uses about 10 amps. How do I know that? We measured it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to operate the fan through this a single strand slash pelito. It should be able to operate it correctly. Okay. All the electricity amperage needed to operate those 10 amps are going through this pelito. Now the pelito is a little bit warm, a little bit. The size of the pelito is going to help explain how the amps works. This can handle 10 amps. Let's go to a smaller pelito. Okay, I changed the size of the wire and the size of the pelito. You can probably barely see it. This is a smaller pelito. Let's see if this size pelito can handle 10 amps. Watch the pelito. Oh no, it melts. The pelito is too small to handle the amperage. It's the size of the pelito. To be more technical, it's the size of the element. Let me put images up on the screen so you can see the difference in the 5 amp, the 10 amp, 20, 30, 40, 50, 100 amp. It's the size of the element that is between the terminals, just like the size of the pelito. The fuses, they do not regulate or control. They do one thing. They protect us. They protect us from fire. Cars, vehicles, trucks should not catch fire. Sometimes they do. You have to be so careful when you're working with electrical, especially if you're adding circuitry. All additional accessories should be protected, not only protected, but protected with the correct size fuse. The fuse and the pelito are the same thing. Is it time to go to our favorite place? At least my favorite place. Let's go to the hood. Okay, here it is. One of the best assignments I've ever come up with. The students were all required to do what I called was the pelito setup. The pelito represents electrical protection from fire. Now, it took quite a while for them to get up to this setup. First, they had to make jumper wires. Making the jumper wires helped them to learn how to work with the wires, the solder, the crimps. They had to make jumper wires. They had to make some pelitos. They had to learn how to use a meter, and they had to learn how to hook it up in series. All the electricity that I'm about to use goes through this single pelito. Like right now, there's some kind of electronics that's drawing a very small amount. Now I'll ask my partner, can you give us some parking lights, please? So the parking lights should come on, and I'm reading about 2.5 amps. The pelito. If I disconnected it, the lights would go off. All the electricity to operate this. Now, so far, the pelito is not even warm. Okay, we're gonna take it up a little bit. Can I get some headlights, please? Okay. We're up to 7.5 amps. I'm pretty sure you see the headlights. And if you look at the pelito, okay, I'm gonna tell you, it's a little bit warm, but it's not red yet. Now, I think I got it just right. If everything goes right, I'm gonna ask for some high beam, and I'm gonna say back off, and watch what happens right here. High beam, back off. Did you see that? The pelito started to melt because I started to operate too many amps. Oh, let me measure. I'm going to measure. We're almost done here, and then we'll summarize. All the electricity to operate the parking lights, headlights, can go through this size pelito. It is the size of the element in the fuse that determines the limit. And I'll make sure you understand that is the purpose of the protection, is to limit. Right here, I'll give you some numbers. Right now, we have 7.25 amps. I'm gonna go ahead and let it burn. I'm gonna tell you what the number of this pelito limit was, and that was the assignment that the students had to do. They had to set this up. And they'd start off with a medium palito or the big palito, and they'd work around and they would measure. They would see. They would understand. Okay, let's see, we have 7 1/4. Can you give me some high beam, please? 14. I'm at 14. About 14. And it looks like it did its job. The electrical protection did its job. That's what fuses do. They limit. This particular one, what did I say? 17. If you go above 17, the fuse gets too hot because there's too many amps.
How it helps my students understand electrical protection, amperage, and measurements. Most of the time, they liked it. One student, George Krumbach, he liked that funny name so much, he swears he named his dog after it. Tim Salisbury thought it was the stupidest thing he's ever seen. Thank you for the view, folks. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up again. If you learned something, hit that notice bell so we can keep you updated. And the most important thing, if you had a little fun learning, that's our specialty. If you haven't subscribed, please do so. We're so close to meeting our first goal. Thank you for the view. Share it with your friends.